Hi everyone, this is Elizabeth Ann Wallace, author of Extraordinary Hope, and many of y'all have heard me from me before as I did Facebook Live teaching series last year, and I thought I'd give you a break because I didn't want you to be worried about or just get tired and, you know, you just get immune to when you hear people too much, but it just seems like the time that we should be talking about hope. And I think a lot of people's hope tanks may not be full. They may be really struggling with where we are as a country and as a people. And so I just wanted to take a few minutes to pray and then just give you a few things. And this is what I'm going to call my hope moment. So we're just going to take it day by day and see what God wants to do. So if y'all will just pray with me, I want to pray for everyone watching right now, everyone that's going to be watching. I want to just lift up this time in prayer really quickly. Father, we just love you so much. We thank you. We thank you for this time, Father, for we know that you're going to bring good out of it. No matter how desperate, how uneasy it may feel within our spirits, Father, I just pray that you give us a peace and a calm that passes all understanding right now in Jesus' name. I pray, Father, that those that don't know you will begin to seek you, Father, to find that peace and comfort and calm in the midst of this crisis that's upon the whole world right now, Father. But we know that you are in charge and that you have asked your people to come forth and to pray for everyone, everywhere concerning this situation. Father, we pray right now that you would just be with us in this hope moment as we just share a few words from your word, Father, that will bring us comfort and peace and joy. And I thank you, Father, and I pray that just every word that comes forth out of my mouth would be from your heart, Father, and not anything else of the flesh, Father. We thank you, Papa, for in your presence, all are healed, all are at peace, and all is good, Father. We ask these things in Jesus' mighty name, amen. I just love the fact that God is with us all the time, but there's a lot of people that don't know that. There's a lot of people that are struggling with it. I was so excited last night when I turned on the news after not watching it all day, just to kind of see what the latest update was from the president and from the government. And they actually had a Presbyterian minister on Fox News last night talking about Jesus and talking about how people can have hope. I was just amazed at that. When else would we have seen that, guys, except for this crisis right here? How exciting is that? Because people are really struggling. And the question that came out is, what about those people that are not Christians, that don't know Jesus? How are they to find hope? And so he began talking about that, because we know there is no other source except for Jesus Christ. So I want to open with something that I want you to be thinking about. And I don't know if you can hear in the background, I have K-Love on right now. I have my praise music constantly on. And when I feel something, I just turn it up. So I hope that y'all got some praise music playing in the background, because that praise music breaks barriers, and we want to break the barrier of fear. And you can see in my shirt, I've got faith overcomes fear. And I love that Jensen Franklin talked about that Sunday in his message that the president and other people ask us to watch. If you didn't see that service at Free Chapel, turn it on, because he talked about that when the Lord went into a house where the young girl had died, she was about 12 years old, and people were all upset. And of course, we can't think of a worse tragedy than a death, right? And Jesus said it was much ado about nothing. Much ado about nothing. And so when I woke up this morning and I had my quiet time, I heard the Lord say again, it's much ado about nothing. Not that we are taking this lightly. Don't misunderstand me. But what I believe the Lord is saying is, he's got this. He's got this. He's watching everything. Angels are being activated right now to go all over the world to fight the enemy, to fight the pandemic, to bring about hope, to bring about solutions. And of course, there's going to be an announcement today from the president at 11 a.m. I'm going to be tuning in to watch that. They've got some good news for us. So I want you to, as you watch the news, I want you to sift it. I want you to check it out, because there is a lot of fake news out there right now. There are a lot of false prophets that are sending words out there right now. And I want y'all to be wise. I want you to be wise, because you need to know what the truth is. And I want you to sift it through what the Father's saying. So if you hear something, don't immediately just share it. I want you to check out the source. I want you to double check. And of course, we know if it doesn't line up with the truth of God's word, it's a lie. And so right now we're hearing a lot of half truths and half lies, and we have got to be wise. So I want to also encourage you and let you know, in Jeremiah chapter 17, verses 7 and 8, I just want you to know what happens when we trust in the Lord and our hope is in Him. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, whose hope is in Him. So we're going to be blessed right now. If our hope is in the Father and we are trusting in Him, we are going to be blessed. And I want you to be blessed. Come on. God is our Jehovah Jireh. He is our provider. Not man, not our company, not our government, the Lord. And He said that He will never allow the righteous to be begging for bread. We have never seen that, and we will not see that. The Lord has supernatural provision for us, and we don't understand where it comes from. And it's not that we're to seek it out. The Lord's just going to provide it. Come on. I want to hear from some of y'all that somebody has brought something to you, that you've been had an unexpected gifting. I mean, it's just going to be unbelievable, the miracles that are going to come from this, the revival that's going to come from this. You know, the Lord went to the cross for the joy that was set before Him. I want you to think about that for a minute, for the joy that was set before Him. We need to think about the joy that's going to come out of this. Not the detriment, but the joy. Listen, the Lord can turn it around just like that. And I am looking for Him to do so. I am looking for Him to do incredible things. I have just been amazed about hearing about the earthquakes, both in South Carolina, North Carolina, and Tennessee. Of course, yesterday they had an earthquake in Utah that shook the Mormon temple, which I thought was very interesting. In fact, it knocked the trumpet out of the angels' hands on top of the on top of their temple. Come on. I mean, this is amazing stuff that we are hearing right now. I just want you to ponder all these things in your heart, like Mary did about the things that she heard about Jesus. I want you to write down maybe dreams that God's speaking to you, maybe things that you're hearing. I just want you to go deeper. I mean, I cannot imagine what God is telling people right now. And one thing that we know, as the harvest comes through, that He will, as He starts pulling His church out and reaping that harvest, we're going to be unified in what we're hearing from the Lord. We're going to know what to do next. Our job is to spread hope. Our job is to continue to praise. And we know from the story in Paul and Silas that their praise broke open the prison doors and set all the prisoners free. Their praise. So we have got to be praising Him right now. We cannot be caught up in, oh Lord, what's going to happen? We have got to be praising Him, okay? So I want you to be doing that, and you'll be surprised at the joy that comes from that. Lord, I mean, I'm doing things that I haven't been able to get to because of the way things are changing, that we're supposed to be at home. I'm actually pressure washing my driveway. And so I came in to do this for you, to give you some hope. But anyway, I just want y'all to be doing those things that we normally don't get to do. You know, sometimes these things happen when we have a hurricane, or we have a flood, or anything like that, like we've had in the past. So take this time and make the most of it. Encourage those around you, maybe those that don't know Jesus, maybe begin helping them see Him, you know, by sharing the word. So I wanted to give you another thing. I want you to do this too. Not only do I want you to have praise music, I want to be praising Him, but I want you to read Psalm 91 every day over yourself. And I'm going to read that while we're here really quickly. But I also want you to do one other thing, and that's to read Psalm 121. And I want you to put your name in the blanks as we're talking about the Lord watching over you. The Lord is the shade at your right hand. I want you to put your name in those blanks. So Psalm 121 in the Bible and Psalm 91. Psalm 91, I want you to read over yourself every day. I also want to make sure you cover yourself in the armor every day so that you're ready for all the things that the enemy is going to send against you. You're going to be ready. You're going to be covered. And so I want you to do those two things, and then we're going to share some other things over time. Now, I want to tell you another thing that I thought was very interesting that happened for me. I had an exercise where I went to a conference, and they asked us to write on a piece of wood something that we didn't want in our life anymore, and look what I wrote. I wrote, I wanted no more fear. And then on the back of this piece of the wood, they asked us to write down the things that we really wanted in our life. And mine was boldness to be transferred to other people. I wanted God confidence. I wanted my family and everyone I met to have any God confidence. So those were the things that I asked for. I wanted to be bold and God confident. So one of the things they had us do, and I have never taken a karate class in my life, is they wanted us to ask the Lord for His strength, not our own, to break this board in half. Now imagine that. Okay, I've never had a karate class. They ask us to do that through the Lord's strength, not our own. And after, I think, three attempts, I broke the board in half with my hands. So no more fear. And I'm telling you, the power that came from tapping in to the Lord's strength outside of my own was unbelievable. That fear in me was broken like nobody's business. And I know He can break that fear in you. So whatever fear you are feeling, I want you to ask the Lord right now to give you the confidence, His strength, not your own, but His strength to break through that, that it'll be gone in Jesus' name, that there'll be nothing but hope to replace it. Nothing but boldness that you can pass on to other people. Nothing but joy, unspeakable joy. And I just pray that that encourages you. Friends, we are all in the same boat. I'm telling you, God is holding the church right here in His hand. And I pray that you are resting in that right now, for He is the one who holds you. Your name is written in the palm of His hand. He has all the hairs on your head numbered. He knows what your needs are. And sometimes we don't know, because we have so many desires and wants, we don't know what our needs are. So I encourage you to tap into, Lord, what are my needs, and meet those needs. And so if you want to get my book, you're welcome to go on. You know, that's up to you, but it will encourage you in 30 days. You've got stories every day. I'm not going to talk about this all the time because I'm not worried about that. What I am concerned about is you. It was interesting because we had just written a Bible study and we were actually doing it at a church, and what timing? Come on. Only God knew that. But I want to give you a couple other things that I thought were very interesting. And it's the scripture from Romans 15, 13. Now may the God of hope fill you with all joy. What did I talk about? That praise brings joy, which breaks prison doors, which gets us through, right? And peace. In believing, that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. We want to abound in hope, people. We want to be filled with His joy and peace. And so I want you to pray that over yourselves, Romans 15, 13. These are the things that you're going to anchor and hang on to. These are the things that are going to get you through this time. These are the things that need to be your focus. And if you have a prayer request, I want to hear it. I want to be able to pray for you. I want to be here for you. And this, my friends, is your hope moment. I love you, and I look forward to hearing from you. I want to hear all the good things. Please message me, call me, let me know what is going on. And until we meet again, I love you. This is your hope moment. Have a great, blessed day.